So now we're going to look more formally at the construction of a truth table. So you may recall that in the construction of a truth table, we list all Boolean variables and assign all possible pairs of truth values to each of these Boolean variables. So either they're both false, one is false and one is true, or they're both true. And now to formally define or to construct a truth table, we need to know how to expand our state, this function, over connectives. So we use these functions called Boolean functions, which take inputs from the set of truth values and return values in the same set. So they take as input the truth values false and true, and output a truth value telling us the truth value of applying this corresponding connective to the corresponding variables, depending on the truth value it has according to the value it has assigned to it by the state. So making this formal, you may recall how to construct the truth values or the truth table according to each of these connectives. So for example, if we apply the negation to the variable x, and x has the following truth values given by different states, or all possible states that it could have, then we know that negation simply gives us the opposite truth value. So if it's false, it's true. If it's true, it's false. Similarly, if we have x and y as our two Boolean variables, and we want to form the new well-formed formula x or y, and determine the truth value corresponding to the different states that these variables are in, then we essentially think of, as long as we have one or the other, then it's true. So if at least one of the variables is assigned truth value true, then or of those two variables is also assigned truth value true. So the only case that it's false is if both values are false. One thing that was taken for granted when you studied truth values before was this formal notion of a state. So essentially what we're looking at here is all possible states for the pair of Boolean variables x and y. So one function can assign them both false. A different state assigns one false, so x false and y true. A different state assigns x true and y false. And a different state assigns x true and y true. And these are all possible states considered here for these two variables. And we're considering what happens when we apply the different Boolean connectives to them. And this is what we call these Boolean functions. So this tells us how to expand the state to these new well-formed formulae. So continuing to review how we construct the truth value over these connectives, recall that for and, essentially, it's going to be true if we have both variables. So if both of them are true, then the truth value for x and y will be true, but otherwise, if at least one of them is false, then the truth value is false. For implication, recall we can read this as if x, then y. So if x is true, then y is true is a true statement. So that makes sense. But if we have x, so x is true, but y is false, we don't have y, then this is a false statement, right? If x, then y. If we have x, then we should have y. But in the case that y is false, that makes that implication false. The reason that these two truth values are both true is because x is false. So if we don't have x, then there's really nothing to check, and simply we assign the truth value to the implication to be true, because it doesn't matter whether we have y or not, because we don't have x, there's nothing to check, and vacuously we define this to be true. Finally, for the equivalence, this is like the variables being equal to each other, right? Logical equivalence means they have the same truth values. So If they have the same truth values, then this Boolean function gives the truth value true. If they have different ones, then it gives the truth value false. Okay, so that's a quick refresher of how to construct the truth values over these connectives. The difference in our class is simply that we're formalizing how to construct this meaning, how to construct these truth values, by making sure that it's well defined. So defining these Boolean functions, and then using these Boolean functions to expand our notion of a state. So recall, originally we defined a state simply to be assigning truth values to Boolean variables and Boolean constants. So now essentially what we're doing is expanding our state by recursively defining how to expand it over different well-formed formulae. So basically we're telling ourselves how to expand it over the formula calculation over each of the Boolean connectives by using these Boolean functions we just defined. Notice here, right, we're still studying within the meta theory, right, because we're using these variables, string variables, that are not within our well-formed formula. So these are just placeholders to help us recursively define this state, which is also outside of logic, right? So this is what's providing the meaning, giving the truth values to each of our statements. Also, just to clarify, whenever we see this bold P, this is also a symbol outside of logic, right? But the bold P just means to represent any possible Boolean variable. So again, it's just a different kind of variable. Okay, so the way this works is to define the state of not A, so applying the negation to any well-formed formula in which we can define the state there, we simply apply the corresponding Boolean function to that truth value given by the state of this. And we recursively construct these based on by applying these Boolean functions. Okay, so that is the formal definition of how to construct a truth table. Since it's formally defined, then we can check to make sure that nothing funny happens, we don't get any contradictions or any paradoxes in this way. However, in our class, you should still just think about constructing truth tables as you normally would, because it's the same idea. That information that we just went through was hidden in discrete mathematics, and formally you can think of it as being hidden here as well. We just want to formalize it so that you sort of know what's going on in the back end or in the background. All right, so in the next section, we'll provide some more formalization to give you all of this background knowledge that you need. And then in class, we'll apply all of these concepts. Mm-hmm.